Very good evening to everyone. It's a great honor to be present here today, and I'm in awe of all the dignitaries over here. Appreciate what Rahul ji has done with this university. This is the first time I'm meeting him also. We don't know much about each other, but I think that this is a wonderful thing that they have done. About religion, I mean, we have Christianity, we have Islam, we have several of them. There are so many of them, and yet they're so different. Allow me to tell you a short story. There were four travelers, a Persian, a Greek, an Arab, and a Turk. They, upon entering a small town, they decided to get something to eat. Having a limited amount of money, they could only decide on one item. So when asked, the Persian said, "Angur." The Greek said, "Staphylion." The Arab said, "Anib." And the Turk proclaimed, "Uzum." They began quarreling about which of these items was the right thing for everyone. A passerby heard them. He came, he took their money, and he bought a bunch of grapes, and he gave it to them. They all became silent. Do you know why? They were all referring to the same item, but the name was different, the manner was different. This passerby then took these grapes, put it in a container, and he pressed it hard. He took out the juice and gave it to each of these travelers. He then threw away the skin of the grapes. He was stepping out when he whispered, "My friends, it's not about what's on the outside that matters. It's the inside. It's the essence that matters." Similarly, we have so many religions. They might have a different outer crust, but the essence, the final destination, is exactly the same. At this point, I want to leave you with a question. Is there any real religion of terrorism? I'm not going to answer that. It's food for thought. Also, broaching the topic of international terrorism, how is terrorism defined? It's defined in several ways. However, I want to stick to one part of it, which says that terrorism is an act which leaves innocent people with negative psychological impacts. Do you believe that terrorism is out there? Is it the work of a bunch of people who are determined to destroy this world that you have created with such pain? It's easy to think like that. In fact, I'd go ahead and say it's convenient to think like that. What if I told you that all of us, me the most, has been spreading terror? When I harbor long-standing hatred towards someone, am I not spreading discord and disharmony? When I, young and fit, watch an old man cross the road and I do nothing to help him, am I not spreading cruelty? When I do not appreciate a meal that has been prepared for me with so much pain and effort, when I do not appreciate a gift that has been given to me by a friend with much thought and effort, am I not spreading sadness? When I incessantly honk a poor vegetable vendor who's pushing his cart uphill on a hot summer afternoon while I sit cozy and comfy in my air-conditioned vehicle, am I not spreading anguish? Am I not a terrorist? On this day, on this lovely day, on this occasion of this global, on the summit of spirituality and science and spirituality for world peace, I think it is an opportune time to look within. Instead of trying to change people outside, it's time to change ourselves. Unless the collective consciousness of all of us changes, there will be true peace will not be possible. When we decide, the only thing that we should be bothering to do every day is think about whether we are better than we were yesterday. It does not matter where your friends are. It does not matter what your colleagues have achieved. The only thing that matters is where you are today versus where you were yesterday. Trust me, friends, everybody's journey is different. Everybody's path is different. Make no external comparisons. External comparisons are the breeding ground for unrest. And this unrest is what probably turns us into mini terrorists every day. In summation, I want to say that unless we change the thoughts that we put out every day, our thoughts and actions are extremely powerful. We will not be able to restore world peace. And only once we begin our inner journey can we hope to restore peace. First within ourselves, then in our families, then in our cities, then in our country, and finally in the world. Today, before leaving you, I want to stand here and make a pledge. I pledge that from today onwards, I will stop spreading terror. Will you all join me? Thank you.